In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me, Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ.
O God, who cause the minds of the faithful to unite in a single purpose, grant your people to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that amid the uncertainties of this world our hearts may be fixed on that place where true gladness is found. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees and hypocrites! You are like a whitewashed tombs, which appear beautiful on the outside, but inside are full of dead men's bones and every kind of filth. Even so, on the outside you appear righteous, but inside you are filled with hypocrisy and evildoing. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees and hypocrites! You build the tombs of the prophets and adorn the memorials of the righteous, and you say, if we had lived in the days of our ancestors, we would not have joined them in shedding the prophets' blood. Thus you bear witness against yourselves that you are the children of those who murdered the prophets. Now fill up what your ancestors measured out. The Gospel of the Lord. So Jesus has been on hold the past couple of days. He's really letting the Pharisees and the scribes have it. He's picking up where he left off yesterday, condemning their hypocrisy. And I like this image he uses today. You're like whitewashed tombs, right? Very beautiful on the outside, but inside full of bones and every kind of filth. Their focus, of course, he's saying, is on the outside and not on the inside. But I'm not so sure that the Pharisees know this or understand this. They seem to believe that they are righteous. In that first reading, Paul's talking about living and walking with the Lord and participating in the community. And I think the Pharisees are kind of saying, well, you know, we are doing the right stuff. And those guys who killed the prophets back then, we're not like that. We're different. And I think that they probably believe that. We wouldn't hurt those prophets. And yet, we know what's coming with their relationship with Jesus Christ. They don't see in themselves what they see in others, their ancestors and those around them. I think that this gospel passage really is an invitation to self-reflection. So often, that's an aspect of our religiosity, of our piety that we skip, or we kind of gloss over. At least I know I've been prone to that. But that inner reflection helps draw us closer to God. We can actually sit and say, well, I'm trying to be good. And I think I'm doing a pretty good job. But where am I not quite there? Where is that little bit of dead man's bones or filth inside me that still needs to be tidied up a little bit? Self-reflection. So Jesus urges the Pharisees to that. And as he speaks, he urges us to the same. He also blesses us with the power of the church to deliver his God's grace of absolution. And so following that self-reflection, of course, we've got that great sacrament of confession available to us. That's what I think this message is today. Not to forget about self-reflection as we seek to move closer to God. Trusting in the Lord of peace to meet all of our needs, we bring our petitions before him. For the church, may God grant within her people a purity of heart and genuine witness of his love. Let us pray to the Lord. For all in positions of governmental and civic leadership, may Christ inspire them in modeling self-sacrifice. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who suffer, may the Lord sustain them through his loving presence and the generosity of his people. Let us pray to the Lord. For this community of faith, may God look favorably and generously upon the work of our hands, that it may be for his glory. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who have died, may they rejoice in the gift of everlasting life. Let us pray to the Lord. For Alice Arthur, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord. And for the end of this pandemic and for all those intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts.
We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
loving Father, we thank you for hearing our prayers and ask that you answer them according to your holy will, through your Son, Christ. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands have become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands has become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, who gained for yourself a people by adoption through the one sacrifice offered once for all, bestow graciously on us, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace in your church, through Christ. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy. Through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you all holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and John our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever. Peace to the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Complete within us, O Lord, we pray, the healing work of your mercy, and graciously perfect and sustain us, so that in all things we may please you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.